So, hello students. It is given book page number 123, task 1. To see the topic, before that I want to give you some introduction what we are going to study in the class, today's class. We see, I write some words here, dog, everything given in the book only, then words. Then people. You know, just words, dog, separate, words separately and people. I want to give some special attention or additional information for this word. So here I write a barking dog. So that I have formed a group of words. Dog is a word. A barking dog means a group of words. A barking dog. Then words. My new words. Group of words. Then people. The wise people. Not simply people. Wise people. You see the special difference of the people or wise people. Here wise gives more attention for the this people. Not only simply they are people, they are wise people, we are saying. Not only simply it is a watch my father gave me, it is a new watch. Not only it is a dog means ever it is barking only, so it is a barking dog. And for this group of words, I can write in another way also. For barking, new and wise, I want to give more emphasis, give more importance for this word. So how I am writing? We are writing a dog that is barking. So a barking dog is now written as a dog that is barking. And here you are writing my words. What about this word? That is new. It is simply not only a word, it is a new word. Then, what about the people? The people who are wise. People means a third person, so that you are using who. That means think. So that you are using that relative pronoun here we are using. So we give some name for this. Here what is the difference between this group of words? Here also group of words. But we have some difference here that then who. And see one more difference. Here we see the verb is then are. So, in the patina, we see that and the verb. So, that now we give the name for this. Before giving name, we write the definition. We give the name. Here, you give the name as praise and it is class. Now, we can write the definition for this. Praise is a group of words. I just stop this. Here you write. A class is a group of words. Then what is the difference between this? With what? With a finite verb. Here we have a finite verb is. Then or like that, with a finite verb. Here, no verb at all. So, without a finite verb. Without a finite. This is the difference between a praise and a class. Here, what about the meaning? It does not give a complete sense. A complete meaning. Here also, it sometimes it gives complete meaning, sometimes it may not. So here you write, it may or may not give a complete meaning. So now we have learnt difference between what is meant by praise and what is meant by class. So what about the third? This we told as finite verb, and that who are called as class marker. It is marking. We call this as class marker. And we see one sentence. Now I write one sentence. I have lost the watch that you gave me. I have lost the watch that you gave me. Now, I have lost the watch. You study this. I have lost the watch. The meaning is complete. Here we get complete sense or complete meaning. Learn this. That you gave me. Not complete meaning. Not complete sense. When it gives a complete meaning, when it depends on this sentence, it gives all these are class. This is class, a group of words with a finite verb. This also class, a group of words without finite verb, complete meaning, isn't it? So because we are finding that the class marker, now we give the name as for this main class. Since it depends on main class, we give the name as subordinate class. What is meant by subordinate? Substitute. Yeah, suppose if one teacher has not come, means we put another teacher for acting and she is known as a subordinate teacher. Isn't it? Or in other way also you can say. So yeah, subordinate class depends upon main class for its meaning to be completed. So we have learnt main class and subordinate class. Now we come to the topic complex sentence. And this is known as complex sentence. This is complex sentence with that. If you find the class marker that, we come to know that it is a complex sentence. So now that you can write the definition for complex sentence. A complex sentence is a sentence with what? With a main class or main class and one or more subordinate class. Not only one subordinate class, more subordinate class also coming. Subordinate classes. So in this topic we have seen about complex sentence. So in the next class we see the book page number 123, task 1, under 10 sentences are given that we do.